I've opened a tournament once before when I played Wayne Jones at the Grand Prix in 2009. It was quite a quiet atmosphere then, but I don't expect it to be like that tonight. Taylor's on the same bill. You expect a big crowd, and I'll definitely give it my all to get that crowd right up. The more I think that Phil's beatable, he'll come back and do something magical. So, you know, I haven't really thought about the fact that Phil's in my quarter. So, you know, if Phil comes around and we're in the last 16 together, great, we'll tackle that when we get there. But as far as Phil goes, I know how much he prepares and how much he wants to win this tournament for, you know. So you can't write him off. When the draw came out and I was drawn against Steve, I thought, you know, I could have been kinder. But I never do anything the easy way. I've only played Steve once before and it was a great game at that time. So it's time to get even, obviously. Steve's got a lot of experience playing for England. He has done exceptionally well on the Pro Tour this year, so he's obviously on a wave of confidence. But hopefully, you know, I can get in front early and make him uncomfortable. That is what I'm actually looking to do in this game. Get a good start, get on top of him and stay there. So let's see how he handles it and see how he handles the asset too. My preparation really has been more mental going into this tournament because I want it to be positive. I've changed a lot of the music that I've been listening to, so I'm not looking back, I'm actually looking forward. I come into this venue just as much in awe of the actual arena and the tournament as I did 2 years ago. I've played a lot of stage darts this year, so going onto that stage doesn't really hold any demons for me. I feel that every game I've played on that stage, I've played my heart out. And, you know, yes, I got beat by Terry Jenkins in the first round last year, but the preparation wasn't ideal, having, say, 45, 50 minutes after walking 3 miles in the snow. If I can get through tonight, give myself confidence and get back down here Christmas Day to go into the second round, I definitely think I could do some damage.
Well, Paul Nicholson was expecting to come out to a raid around North London. Meant the crowd still arriving. It's a key way to kick off the World Championship. But what is Jumbo?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alexandra Palace. This is the Ladbrokes World Darts Championship. Brought to you by the Professional Darts Corporation. We are live on Sky Sports. Time to meet the players. Meet Steve Farmer! And now, ladies and gentlemen, hope you're ready for this, because here comes the asset, Paul Nicholson!
After the Grand Slam victory, what, a year ago now, he hasn't really played as well as we expected him to, Paul Nicholson.
No, after he beat Taylor and went on to win the tournament, which is unusual, normally people fall down over that, he's not done it all year and he's got very frustrated in himself. He needs to relax a bit more. This is a massive game for him, Dave, because this Steve Farmer can go on him and even ruin next year. It's a real toughie, and what a great going to start the tournament.
How difficult is it to open up the show, open up the World Championship, the biggest tournament?
It's extra pressure, no question, because you think if you lose, you're the first one to go home, and you've got to watch this tournament for another 14 days without throwing a dart. Massive pressure. No question.
You remember a year ago he got stuck in the snow, didn't he? He got his preparation all wrong. He was here really early, he got here at 3 o'clock, got his preparations right this time. Steve Farmer looks pretty laid back though, nothing seems to faze him.
Yeah, Farmer is a guy like that. He ain't going to have earphones in there blaring. I think sometimes Paul at times preparation too much, instead of just getting up there and letting his natural ability just get him through the game. And I think there's a few players that do that. They kind of tie themselves up too much, Dave, where Farmer won't let that happen.
And the pressure first round, ruin you Christmas, ruin you if you can.
Yeah, it certainly will, certainly ruin your Christmas, and it ruins next year. You've got to realise money in this. You do well in this tournament, you can sit back a little bit and relax for the go out first on the top of your.
The match should. Sid Woodell.
Well, just apropos that four last year, stuck an eye gate tube, trotted 3 miles through ice. 3 minutes before his game, 45. Lost to Jenkins. But he was brilliant a year before when he got to the quarterfinals. This lad looks like a dark player, Johnny.
Yeah, well-known Steve Farmer in the game, of course. 13 years, a Shropshire County player, played 3 years with West Midlands. He's Shropshire-based, though he's very much a Black Country man. He's a West Brom supporter. And Paul Nicholson here. Yes, you're right, Sid. It was tournament that threw him onto the darting scene. And, of course, we've seen a lot of him since.
Traddy, yeah, and Fitz. They'll be watching the bricklayer's arms at Shrewsbury. Says he'll be all shouting for him. And this lad, North Shields, then went to Oz, where he became the world number one in 2 years, has now moved to Chorley Lanks. And he's finding the red bits. Unlucky.
So they'll be watching him, will they? In which pub did you say in Shrewsbury, Sid?
The Bricklayer's Arms!
Watching the Farmer's Arms!
Hey! Now we've got the Apostles of Darts! And this is his new shirt. Pink makes the girls wink, I used to see her when I had my teddy boy outfit on.
60!
New hairdo! And Farmer, well, from Telford. Tremendous dart, right of it. Does it shake the bricks in Shrewsbury?
Oh, that's up to 140 so far in this match. Yet to see the first maximum of the World Championship 2011. We won't be getting one here because he's going for 161. Needed the treble 17, although no real pressure. And squares it off nicely. 68 left for 175.
Former British Darts Organisation number. He's not far off when he misses over that 90. Red slack dart. First leg, 2011 World Championship. The asset, as he calls himself, needs to capitalise. 216.
Well, that's bound to be, of course, and that's what you want when you start. Get that 100% right from the off, hit that double first dart, and that 41. Can boost confidence no end.
Well, you should be rubbing them presents and feeding them reindeer. What are you doing here? Lovely lie for the red bits, just too high, still a lie.
100.
Bad shot there, Judge, should have taken the lie.
Yeah. When I was stuck on the North Circular this afternoon, yes, it's horrendous traffic. That's why the seats, as Dave Clark was saying, aren't entirely full. An hour to do 4 miles, Sid. And though Santa Claus is at the benefit of the sleigh.
Good then. It's first man of three sets. It's the winner. First of three legs gets you the set. Nice adjustment on an awkward, tricky lie.
100.
Again, should have done better with the third dart.
Yeah, great first. Got a fat.
And we don't have an airport. Take off ground. He has Russell. Me and John try to stay in the slipstream.
Steve, you're required full.
60. Stand corner. High. Wilson. Halfway. Down the red road. Crouch end. Has to get 140.
Yeah, Nicholson won the first leg with throw, but it looks like Farmer. He's on 15 dart. He's going to equal up here. Equalise with this one.
85.
He does it with this dart.
Steve, you require
Goodell take his average into 100. It's 98.44 at the moment. That's not a bad marker. A fraction under. Oh, Nicholson's rather clumsily left himself 30. On a bogey, Sid.
Good point, good point. Right, the Nicholson has to put a bit of pressure here. Needs to take it down and leave a one darter. That's a good start. That's a very good start, John.
Yeah, he's got to come down. Oh, brilliant.
122
left, Sid. And if Farmer can't afford to miss this now, if he does, I fancy Nicholson will step in. That's awkward. Awkward angle. Got to go either side. Comes low. What a chance now for Nicholson to break the throw.
The Jordy Aussie played in Sunderland 2 weeks ago with Whitlock. They played very well up there. It's only won by the Dutch. Here he is in pink for himself. Double 11. Yeah. No bother. You heard his shout. Yeah, he said. In Aussie Jordan.
Well, Farmer will wonder how on earth he lost that leg, because he was well. He had the 13 darter beckoning and rather made a mess of it. He's got to put that behind him. It's his debut on this. Nicholson has almost 2 years ago. Will have him down. He wanted better than 60, didn't he, Sid?
Well, as this lad comes to the hockey, he must know Nico's reputation. In that tournament in Sunderland the other week, had a brilliant match against Canada, 108 average. Then he had